Magandang umaga, kapamilya. Welcome to the ninth day of our Kapamilya Simbang Gabi. This Mass is specially offered for all our families. Let us pray together the Oratio Imperata.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear. May they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all these to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.
Please welcome our Mass celebrant, Father Tito Caluwag, ABS-CBN Chaplain.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Magandang umaga ho at welcome sa ating pangsyam at ang ating final novena mass para sa ating simbang gabi ngayon, ngayong taon na ito. Kagaya nga ng ating pinanalangin sa simula, hinihingi natin yung biyaya na makakita tayo ng higit na malinaw, makapili ng mabuti, at tayo ay makakilos ng tama. Kaya sama-sama tayo ngayon dumulog sa Diyos at hilingin natin sa Kanya ang Kanyang pagpapatawad. Lord, for the times that we did not see clearly, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the times that we did not choose well, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
For the times that we did not act right, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray.
Come quickly, Lord Jesus, do not delay. We entrust ourselves to your love. Strengthen us by your coming and raise us up, you who live and reign with the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading, David wants to build God a house where the Lord can stay close to his people. But God says, it is he who will build a house that is a lasting dynasty for David, from which the Messiah will come.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night, the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I'll raise you up, your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father for him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The favors of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Forever I will confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
He shall say of me, "You are my Father, my God, the Rock, my Savior." Forever I will maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia, O radiant dawn, splendor of eternal light, Son of justice, come and shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Zechariah, his father, filled with the Holy Spirit, prophesied, saying, "Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, for he has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hand of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sa Ebanghelyo, di ba, sa kagaya nung sinabi natin nung Miyerkules, sabi ko, di ba yung awit ni Maria, the Canticle of Mary, the Magnificat, is now probably one of the most beautiful lines in Scripture, the most beautiful canticle, most certainly. And here now you have the Canticle of Zechariah, the Benedictus. No? And here you have, again, a very beautiful song. No? And as we mentioned yesterday, today's Gospel is really, we should reflect on it as one continuous narrative. No? From the naming of John the Baptist in yesterday's Gospel, remember, Zechariah was quiet for 9 months. Kasi di ba, nung sinabihan siya ng anghel na magkakaanak kayo, nagduda siya, no? At dahil doon, tumahimik siya ng 9 buwan at muli siyang nakapagsalita noong pinanganak na si San Juan Bautista. So in a sense, Zechariah was into silence, no? Prayer, silence, reflection. And when he said yesterday his name shall be John, as we mentioned in our reflection, ang kahulugan noon is God is gracious. What Zechariah discovered in those 9 months of silence and prayer was the graciousness of God. Again, see clearly, choose well. And now Zechariah proclaims God's action in history. When he sings the Canticle of Zechariah, if you notice, he traces God's movement in the history of salvation, culminating now in the birth of his son, John the Baptist, who is now the precursor to the Messiah. At makikita natin dito na muli pinapakita ni Zechariah yung pagkilos ng Diyos sa ating kasaysayan, God's action. And this action now culminates in the coming of John the Baptist, and ultimately, as we will celebrate tonight, it culminates in the birth of the Savior. Sa ating 9 na araw ng pagninilay, tayo ay nanalangin na tayo ay makakita ng malinaw, makapili ng mabuti, at makakilos ng tama. At sa pagtatapos ng ating nobina sa ating mahal na Birhen, as we end this 9-day novena of the Simbang Gabi in honor of the Blessed Mother, let us ask ourselves and continue to pray that we may see clearly the light of Christ, that we may see clearly the dawn from on high breaking upon us to shine on the darkness of our challenges now. And let us pray that with the light of Christ, we will be able to choose well. And together with Christ, we may be able to act right. Hilingin natin to sa Diyos sa ating pagtatapos ng ating nobina at sa pagpasok natin ng Kapaskuhan. Sana ay patuloy tayong bigyan ng mga biyayang ito. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The dawn announces the Savior's coming from on high. We welcome Him with eager longing as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Church, the people of God, be set free from fear, hatred, anxiety, and attachment to sin. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May political and civil leaders receive unwavering support from their constituents, whom these leaders must serve with integrity, justice, and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As the season of Christmas draws near, may we strive to live moderately, prudent in our gift-giving, in order to avoid wasteful spending, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Attend to the souls of our dying brothers and sisters. May you reward them eternal life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our families be our source of joy, strength of our faith, and reason for loving God more. And may we be always grateful for our parents, who, like Joseph and Mary, will care and love us most. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, we remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Faithful God, help us to be strong and patient in our difficulties. May we never lose hope in your promise. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Graciously accept, O Lord, the gifts we offer, that our partaking of them may free us from sin and purify our hearts for the glorious coming of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. Grant to us who find new vigor as you have renewed us, Lord, by these wonderful gifts, as we prepare for the mystery of Christ's birth, Grant that we may rejoice in his gift of eternal life. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our 9-day novena of Masses have ended, and so we now prepare for the coming of our Lord as we celebrate the Christmas Mass tonight. Maraming salamat po. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace that we may be ready for the birth of the Savior.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, and we will see you all at our midnight Mass. Thank you.
Days our country, especially Mindanao and Visayas, were hit by the strong typhoon Udit. They are in need of food, need of clothing, medicines, and especially they need materials to restore their homes and their livelihoods. So we appeal to you, our partners, for your generosity. Whatever help you have will mean a lot to them. Thank you very much.